it's Daredevil.
Hmm.
I don't feel so good.
Hmm.
You suck.
I feel a little violated.
Back with another retro review for 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days! And today, we're going to rewind it all the way back to 2001 with a DC Direct action figure. It's the Otherworld's Dead Man with glow-in-the-dark features. Now, I found this at my local half-price books in Greenwood, Indiana, the south side of Indianapolis, and this was one of the Dead Man figures I was actually looking at online to get for 31 Horror Toys last year, and I just happened to come across it for like $7.50 at the local half-price books, and I thought, you know what? I can't pass it up. So let's go ahead and take a look at the packaging. So here we have Dead Man in the packaging, and I love the old school Dead Man logo up here. That is very awesome. Reminds me of comics like from the 70s and 80s, which is very, very cool. We get Dead Man right there. He doesn't come with any accessories, so I guess it's just glow in the dark. But I really remember these old DC action figures, DC Direct figures, which were very cool. They were very, very big in the comic shop in the late 90s and early 2000s. And I wish I would have picked a lot more up now than I did in the past. But yeah, very cool. It's got the DC Direct logo down there. And then it's got, looks like it's got the Demon and the Spectre in the background, which is kind of cool. I'm presuming they are Wave Mates. So yeah, here's the DC Direct logo at the top. Dead Man. He's glow in the dark. And he's obviously glow in the dark, which looks really cool. And then you can kind of see the Spectre back there, and then you can see the Demon. Very nice. And then we got the DC Direct logo down there. But yeah, definitely very cool. I am digging that. Boston is looking all kinds of neat. Then on the back of the package, it's got a write-up for Boston brand here, aka Dead Man. Then it says other figures in this line. We get the Demon, we get Spectre, and then a bunch of other figures that were available. Ooh, the Captain Marvel looks really, really neat. Ah, I remember the Aquaman figure. That was cool. Dr. Fate, that would be one I wouldn't mind having today. And the Sandman. Oh, that would be nice. Or even the Darkseid and Orion. Oh, I may have to go on an eBay hunt for these guys. So yeah, let's take a closer look here. There is Boston Brand, aka the Dead Man. And if you want to pause and read this, you are more than welcome to. And then here's the other part. If you want to pause and read that, you're more than welcome to. And then here are the other two figures that are in this wave. And then here are some of the other figures that you can collect, looking all types of cool. Definitely neat. I loved this series of figures. They were very cool, very neat, very awesome. And I'd love to see some of these come back in the multiverse. I think that would be a lot of fun. So come on, Mattel, jump on that. But that's pretty much the packaging for Dead Man here. Let's go ahead and get him out of package and see what we think. So here we have Dead Man out of the packaging, and this figure is very cool, although he looks very alien. His head is just really weird. He's got some kind of gimpy look going on, and I don't know if that's supposed to be he's kind of ghoulish and ghostly, or if it's just bad QC. Now, I do like the costume. It's very classic Dead Man. It's kind of an older version of the character, which is kind of neat. And I do have to say the glow-in-the-dark feature is very, very cool. I'm going to see if the camera will actually pick it up. So let's see. And you can barely see it in the camera, but it does glow in the dark and it does look really, really cool. So that is definitely very, very fun. As far as articulation goes on this figure, the head moves back and forth. There is no up or down movement. The shoulders come out all the way. They spin all the way around, which is nice. There's a single joint elbow. Nothing at the wrists, unfortunately, nothing at the waist. The legs kick out super far, which is pretty cool. They do twist, but they don't really move all that great. There is a single joint at the knee, and then he's got hinges at the feet, and well, that's about it as far as articulation goes on the guy. It is what it is. It's an older figure. So taking a closer look at the figure itself, I like the sculpt on this figure. It really does remind me of the comic book character. He's very ghostly and ghastly, which I do like. The glow-in-the-dark paint not only looks very ghoulish, but it works. And I definitely dig that. The collar he's got going on is super huge. The muscle tone on the figure is done pretty well, and it's got some really nice shading going on in the muscles, which I really do dig. I don't know if it's a black wash or if it's a black dry brush. It almost looks like an airbrush into the muscles, but it's really, really nice, and again, kind of gives it to that ghastly appearance of Dead Man. And I just absolutely love it. I think it's cool. So looking at the midsection of the figure, there's a lot of red going on here, but that's the costume. Again, I like the muscle tone. It's very thin and wiry. Again, very corpse-like, and I dig that for the character. He's got the classic little D on his body there that also glows in the dark, which is very, very cool. I dig that. His hands could use some articulation, at least some swivel. That right hand is a really weirdly sculpted hand, and it just looks awkward in any position that you put him in. But again, the black wash or secondary paint, airbrushing, whatever that is on the figure, definitely looks cool, and it really brings out the muscle tone on the character. And finally, taking a look at the legs of the figure, this one's a little different than the other Dead Man figures in the fact he's got those classic booties on with the little wing tips on the back. They really remind me of like Robin in the 60s and 70s all the way up until about the 80s, I think. And I think Green Arrow had a pair of booties like this as well. I'm not really sure why the characters had them like that back in the day, but this definitely harkens back to an older character, which I like in Dead Man because, well, he's Dead Man and he should have been dead for a long time. I think that's a good idea. For comparison, so here we have Dead Man with Dead Man and Dead Man. That's a lot of Dead Man figures right there. Which is really, really funny. While I like the character, I never really thought I would have three variations of the character, but that's okay. So we've got the DC Icons version here. We have this DC direct figure here, and then we've got the Brightest Day version down here where he's actually alive. And, you know, it's kind of funny. I will say that the Icons figure has the best articulation, very, very close to a Marvel Legends figure. These two figures have similar articulation, although this one is a wee bit more articulated. But as far as interpretation of the character, I really kind of like this one here the best. I don't particularly care for his little kind of booties, his Robin-style booties that he's got going on there, but I like the way the head looks. I like the D, the giant, collar that goes up around, which the others have too, but it's not as huge and prominent as the DC Direct version. And when I think about the character, the sculpt on this one really says Dead Man more than the other two. So is the DC Direct Dead Man a figure that you want in your DC collection? Well, if you like the Justice League Dark characters, I think this is a character you're going to like. It's really going to be what kind of Dead Man figure you like, the era of Dead Man, I guess, and what size scale of Dead Man do you like? Personally, I like this one a little bit better than I do the Icons because of the scale and because of the way he looks. While the Icons one is very Marvel Legends-like as far as articulation, which is cool, this one looks more ghastly and more like a corpse, which he should, being Dead Man. So, honestly, I think I like this one a little bit better, and it's glow-in-the-dark. You can't beat that. So there he is, Dead Man, for 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days!
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, thumbs it up. If you hate this video, thumbs it down. To watch more Ultra Maximus, click on the links to the right. Don't forget to subscribe and share, like us on Facebook, and look for more videos in the future.